welcome to my first YouTube video. I am really hoping to connect with other meatheads and just other people who are just really into fitness, who want to know more about fitness, who want to know about food, who just want to browse my YouTube page for no reason. This first video is just going to pretty much be an introduction video, which means I'm going to spend the next couple minutes talking about myself. So, what's this all about? What am I going to be posting on here? I'm not exactly sure yet, but it's going to be in line with my blog. So if you don't follow that, I encourage you to do so. It's www.dumbbellblonde.com, D-U-M-B-B-E-L-L, blonde, B-L-O-N-D-E.com. Hope I spelled that right. I did. please check it out. It's tons of posts about working out, nutrition, motivational posts, advice for any bodybuilders, bikini competitors, stuff like that. There's a lot of information on there. So this is going to correlate with some of that information. So a little bit about me. My name is Heather. I live in Chicago. I am a certified personal trainer. I am a professional journalist. I am a nutritionist in training. I can't wait to get that taken care of pretty soon. I am so passionate about food, especially ice cream. Peanut M&Ms, peanut butter, and any treats that you can eat healthy but taste like it is a treat. If you also don't know, I'm a mom to an 8- and a 4-year-old. They do have fur. I'm a mom to 2 bulldogs, actually. My dogs are being so crazy right now. They're trying to get me to pay attention to them. I know what they're doing right now. They're trying to distract me. Since I've been like 5 years old, I wanted to be a journalist. I wanted to be a reporter. I wanted to meet a whole bunch of different people. I have diaries just like full of, when I am growing up, I want to be a journalist. I don't want a normal job, blah, blah, blah. So that was my game plan since I was little. I went to college, studied journalism. Studied PR. I had a whole bunch of different internships. I actually had an internship at the Today Show, which was amazing. Lived in New York for a summer. It was so poor, but totally worth it. I interned at a few TV stations, got hired out of college, worked at a TV station in Iowa, did traffic there where there wasn't really much traffic, kind of had to just like fill time. It was kind of an interesting, humbling experience. Took a few years off to kind of regather my thoughts. When I was there, it was pretty traditional news, local news, what you see on TV, lots of fires, shootings, government policy, stuff like that. And I didn't really know if that's what I wanted to do anymore, so I kind of took some time off. My husband got a job offer back in Chicago. We actually both grew up in the suburbs. We met when we were in high school, so it was a good opportunity to get back here where our families were. And I had a really interesting job opportunity come about where I was able to style men and sell men's clothing for 3 years. It was an amazing opportunity. It gave me really the confidence that I have now to just be myself, kind of just grab life for what it is and figure out who I was and what exactly I wanted to do moving forward. So in February, I just kind of took like this big leap of faith and decided like, hey, like we only have like right now to live and I'm just going to live. Like I know what my talents are. My talents are talking to people. I want to know people's stories. I want to help people. Like if I would always ask myself like if I were to die tomorrow, which is a scary thought and I don't know if I should think that way, but I would ask myself that all the time, like what type of footprint would I leave on this earth? And oftentimes, like I would just not be able to come up with much. So I knew that even though the job that I was in had been amazing, it had given me such a strong foundation of who I was and like kind of really helped create like who I had been for the last 3 years, I knew it was just time to move on. And that's normal. That's change. That's what being in your 20s is all about. And I really knew what I wanted to do. Or I had some sort of idea. And that's all it takes sometimes is just like that spark. Just need that like little spark. So I knew I wanted to be a personal trainer. Because that was kind of, for me, there's two sides to me. There's that really creative side, which is always writing, which is always journalism, which I'm always going to have my entire life. I was just born with it. And then there's that like really hyper playful tomboy side of me, which has been sports for me, or that's where working out comes in. So, and I like doing both sides. And so, that's where like bodybuilding comes in. I don't know how long, you know, I'll compete for or be in bodybuilding for, but I know that I'm always going to have this passion for food and fitness. And so I decided like I really wanted to get my personal training license. I got certified in June. I have clients who I absolutely adore now. And for me, it's just been an amazing road. Okay, so what have I been doing since I left my job? So my life is freelancing now, which pretty much means that I just am my own boss and I set my own schedule, which just means that life is pretty amazing. Oh yeah, look at my really cool tank top I got at the Arnold Classic this year. It's Arnold, obviously. So how am I making a living? I haven't really figured that out yet. No, I'm just kidding. So, like I said, I got my personal training license in June, so I have some clients who impress the heck out of me. I push them to the extreme. I expect nothing less than them. If they show up and they are tired, they quickly become untired, and I make them do things like flip tires and do battle ropes and do all sorts of weird jumps, and they do it, and they probably hate me, but I love them, and I don't know what my weeks would be like if they all got really sick and decided not to show up at the gym one day. What else have I been doing? I am a freelance journalist, so I work for a really cool TV station here in Chicago, and we work on documentaries, news stories, all sorts of different things. I'm also, since I am a freelance journalist, I take on all sorts of website projects where I write biographies for websites, and also just getting ready for my show up here in November, which I'm really excited for. And I'm also just traveling and just living life and just being really genuinely happy, which I just think is very important. And spending a lot of time with my dogs. And drinking a lot of coffee. Oh, and I started reading a new book, which I haven't done in a long time. Why do I do such weird things? I feel like I do like the weirdest faces, right? Like, no one, I should never have been given a camera. Okay, so at the end of each video, I want to end with something. Just try something new. And if you want to try it for yourself, why the heck not? I mean, life's so short. Just have a little fun. So we're going to do a high of the day, a low of the day, and an interesting fact, funny, weird, like whatever about myself. Okay, my high of the day. You guys, I spend a lot of time alone, so these might be a little bit harder. I'm still trying to think of my high of the day. I didn't have a bad day. Nothing was really eventful one way or the other. Oh, I have it. The high of my day is I'm planning a trip to Whistler, Canada to go snowboarding. Amazing. Amazing. Okay. I feel like I have like marks on my face now from doing weird things. Okay. The low of my day is that it's been, my dog is drinking out of his bowl and it's so loud. Buster, thank you. You're interrupting our conversation. The low of my day is that it's been raining all day and I've had to take my dogs out like 5 times in the downpouring rain. No big deal. Mom's gonna do what mom's gonna do. Okay, so anyone that knows me probably thinks there's something really weird about this video, and that's the fact that I'm wearing makeup. Since I left my job in February, I've probably worn makeup like, I don't know, high guesstimate 15 times, low guesstimate like 10 times. That's probably something that anyone who'd be watching this might be shocked is to see me with makeup on. Look, makeup, mascara. Can you believe it?